Company Data Auditor will actually do several things for you. You can back up and verify the company data set from this point, or you can lock a period. In this case, you can say, I want to lock all transactions prior to January 1st, 2007. This is a good approach if you don't want any more activity in the year 2006, for example. It's a good way to prevent errors, and it's a good way to keep your accounting in check. And also load tax tables from this point. And to do that, you would be running internal payroll, and from here you would load the tax tables directly from MYOB. Also, in the company file overview, you can do an account reconciliation. And what this allows you to do is by account, you can actually see what your balance is, and you can actually see when the last time this account was reconciled and the date, or whether it was ever reconciled at all in the past. So clicking on this account, from here all we see is the account, basic account information. We know that it's a detail account, which means that it's part, or it's a sub-account of a header account. And in our case, it's cash on hand. And here's a description and what type of currency we're using for this particular account. And keep in mind that you can use different currencies, and you can have your bank account set up in a different currency than US dollar. And you can also have your accounts payable and accounts receivable set up in something other than a US dollar. And when that money gets deposited into one of the bank accounts, it will actually get translated, and you would actually, for that deposit, you would actually put in the translation amount that the bank posted that deposit with. In other words, you would put in that exchange rate that the bank used, and so therefore you'd be able to record your gain or loss on the transaction itself. And here is your bank account detail information, your routing numbers, your bank account number, the name of the bank, and the company's trading name, the legal history. And here you can see the history of the account by month. You can see what each balance is at the end of each month, and also what the current balance is. And you can also select a range to look up any particular transaction that you need to look up. And from there, you can drill down to that particular transaction. Third area in the account in the MYOB company file overview is the transaction review. When you run a review for a particular period of time, you will see whether or not the subledgers tie to the general ledger. In this case, if we look at the first line, it says reconcile invoices with linked receivable account. This is telling me that the accounts receivable module is in tie with the general ledger. Second line here says reconcile purchases with linked payables account. This is telling me that the accounts payable module is tied in with the general ledger. And right now we're not using items values, and we're not using future data transactions. We haven't done any of that. If I display this, it will tell us that the inventory module and the general ledger are out of balance by $224.48. And it will also show us the possible causes of these exceptions. And from here, you can actually drill down and try to find where the variance is coming from. So the check marks mean that We're in reconciliation with the subledger, and the question marks mean that we're not in reconciliation with the subledger. And this would give you a valuable tool to try to find out at month end or year end where your differences are. Last but not least is the tax exception review. This review will check for tax amount variances for sales, check for tax amount variances for purchases. Now, you may not be using taxes for purchases necessarily, but a lot of companies will use sales tax So if I run the review there, it says everything's fine. And all that means is that when you run a transaction through sales, it properly posts the sales tax payable to the proper sales tax payable account. And likewise for purchases, if you put a tax amount in there on your purchase, it will post that to a tax expense account.